What's up, everybody? It's Ronald, and I need your help. We're trying to grow the audience of Leaving the Theater, and the first step to doing that is by getting some information from you, my dedicated, loyal, and opinionated listeners. So wherever you're listening right now, please go to the show notes of this episode and click on the link that says Listener Survey. By completing this survey, you're helping to support the growth of Leaving the Theater and Oh, It's Big Ron Studios. We use this information to determine how often we release episodes, if and when you hear ads, what types of ads you'll hear, and generally just to find out who exactly listens to the show. If we know the audience, we can grow the audience. So please, 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 please complete that survey as soon as you can. Once again, it's in the show notes. It's very easy. It takes probably about an average of 6 to 8 minutes to complete. Nothing too intrusive. You will be helping the show. So please, please, please complete that survey. Thank you so much. Now let's start the show. Pixar Animation Studios is the veteran in the room when it comes to making heartfelt, award-winning, critically acclaimed animated features. Their latest movie hopes to continue the trend. Luca tells the story of a sea monster who discovers that he's able to shapeshift as a human when he's on land. He immediately realizes that he wants more from the world than the sea is able to offer him. The only thing that stands in his way is a beachside town of sea monster hating humans. I'm Ronald Young Jr., and I'm on the couch. This is Ronald, and I am on the couch after watching Luca, written by Jesse Andrews and Mike Jones, directed by Enrico Casarosa, starring Jacob Tremblay, Jack Dylan Grazer, Emma Berman, Saverio Raimondo, Maya Rudolph, Marco Barricelli, Jim Gaffigan, and Sacha Baron Cohen. All right, Luca is a movie about a sea monster named Luca who is able to find out that he's able to change into human form when he comes up on land and is fully dry. And as a result, he meets his friend named Alberto, and they go on adventures together until they decide to go to the fishing town, the Italian seaside town of Portorosa, I believe is the name of the town. And they decide to enter a race so that they can win a Vespa and take adventures away from where they are. This movie starts off with very strong Little Mermaid vibes, very much, I want to go where the people are. And the animation is very Wallace and Gromit, I thought, to start off with. I mean, it's definitely a little cuter than I have seen. Like, Pixar always does cute things, but this is definitely like the cutest among the Pixar, the Pixar range, on the cuter end of the Pixar spectrum, if you will. This movie, it starts off, and I was a little bored in the beginning. He's a sea monster underground, and he's hurting these fish, which is pretty fun. I believe this was a movie that was made. I believe it's a joint effort between Pixar and folks in Italy. I should research that, but I had a lot of movies to watch, y'all. So somebody look that up and let me know. Heavily, very much, almost as much an Italian film as it is, except for the fact that it is spoken completely in English. But lots of Italian actors are a part of the voice cast, not top billed, but also to fill out the rest of the town. And obviously an Italian director as well. Is that true? Yes, it is true. Also an Italian director as well. So you know, I'm going to try to put these up in order so that you guys can kind of get my progressive way of thinking. But I've now seen Encanto. I've seen the Mitchells versus the Machines. I've seen Raya and the Last Dragon. And I've seen Luca. Luca is the only Pixar movie of the bunch. Now, there was a time. Oh, and I'm sorry, I forgot to say, this movie was nominated for Best Animated Feature. That's it. So once again, this is the only Pixar movie in the bunch. There was a time period where if Pixar owned, they should have just called the Best Animated Feature the Pixar Award, because Pixar cleaned up every single year. Pixar was getting an award in the Best Animated Feature category every single year. I mean, you could just go down all the classics. I believe The Incredibles, Toy Stories, Finding Nemo, all of them. You go back to the early ones, Pixar was just cleaning up left and right. Nobody could knock them off that pedestal. Things have changed. You know, the playing field is a little more even now. Disney Animation Studios, Disney owns Pixar now, but Disney also, you know, has its own animation studios. It makes Disney-fied movies, and it came out with two, and it's nominated in two categories. So Disney has three of the five, if we're being honest. Disney has Encanto, Disney has Luca, and it has Raya and the Last Dragon. This movie is classic Pixar. It's classic. You know, it's a coming-of-age story, which is good, but it's very much like Pixar likes to tell a little story. You know, it likes to make extraordinary circumstances behind what's basically a little story. And this is just a little story. This is a guy who wants to, he wants to leave his small town and go see the rest of the world. That's the story. And they keep that to the very heart. But the emotional beats, there are several emotional beats in this movie that are very, very strong, and they all happen towards the end of the second act into the third act of the movie. And it's interactions between Luca and his best friend Alberto. Those, they're really the heart of the entire story. Their friendship is at the heart of this movie, and the interactions between the two of them really hold a lot of this movie together in a way that's just, I teared up at the very end of this movie, and I didn't expect that to happen. I did not tear up at the end of Encanto, which I think is the strong favorite. And I mean, the messaging in Encanto was like still very strong, but I think this one just felt a little bit more emotionally resonant with me. There's themes of sacrifice. There's themes of, you know, when you got your friends and you guys have two different plans for what you guys want for your life, and it takes you in different directions. Man, I'm getting choked up now thinking about it. But thinking about what those differences look like. You know what I mean? And what the rest of your life looks like. And Pixar is very good at taking a single idea again and letting extraordinary circumstances be animated behind it, but just boiling it down to one little thing. Like if you go to Finding Nemo and you think about the fact that, you know, it's really about a son not wanting to lose, a father not wanting to lose his son. And, you know, it's also a little fish goes on a big adventure and finds and, you know, runs into the sea turtles and the sharks and the sharks and, you know, gets into the fish tank and all that stuff. But at the heart of it, it's just a father looking for his son. And Pixar does very good at that. And I remember this movie came on after watching those other movies, Mitchell's vs. Machine and Encanto and Raya and the Last Dragon. As it came on, I'm just like, you already feel that Pixar difference. Pixar does a very good job of taking its movies seriously. Like they don't make kids movies. You know, they make movies that, you know, that like with very complex emotional themes, you know, but just, you know, with very simple and beautiful storytelling. It's like both, because this is something like the emotions in this run deep several times. There's the conflict between the two friends, one wanting one thing, one wanting the other. But it's really just them revolving around wanting to do this bike race that's in this little seaside town. And then there's this entire seaside town of villagers who hate sea monsters. And these two little sea monsters are hiding out as humans, and they're afraid, and they don't want to be found out. And then and the way that that can, you know, talk about people who are different from us and what that means, why we're afraid of them, why we want to go after them, all that. So it's just, it tackles all of that, and it does it in a much, in a simple way. And there's something about, it doesn't feel ham-fisted, you know? For me, it doesn't feel ham-fisted. I don't know if that's the case for everyone who watches this movie. I didn't feel that way. I felt that way with Raya and the Last Dragon. It felt ham-fisted. And probably because the villains in Raya and the Last Dragon don't really have any origin. We don't know where they came from. They just showed up. These characters in this movie, like, they're, and I don't, and it's weird because I'm sitting here looking at, I'm trying to think of my complaints with Raya and the Last Dragon. I thought the characters were flat. In this one, it's not like they did that much more work to tell me about these characters, but the little stories that they did tell gave me enough to give stakes to everybody. You know, at one point, Alberto is very upset about the friendship that's happening between Luca, and they found a human friend, Julia, and their friendship is beginning to blossom. And all of a sudden, Alberto seems very jealous. And when it's revealed why Alberto's upset or why he feels so possessive of his friendship of Luca, you can't do nothing but just be like, oh man, yeah. No, I get it. No, that I get it, Alberto. And then later on, when, you know, he and Luca just, you know, they just sell out for each other later in this movie as the best friends. It just it hits all of these emotional beats very well. And it's wild because I didn't hear a lot of people talk about this movie. You know, Encanto came out late in the year and it's really taken over all the conversations, and it's a musical. People could sing along. It's been popular. Like, it was, it came on Disney Plus very quickly. There was no premiere package. You could just watch it. Luca came out in the summer and it was, you know, people were still having hot Ron summer. I'm sorry, hot insert your name here, summer, doing their thing. And you know, maybe it slipped by, but this is a little movie where if you didn't get a chance to watch it, I would encourage you to go back and watch Luca. This was, it was just a cute, very sweet movie. And I think it being a smaller story helped it be effectively told. This movie was it was an hour and 41 minutes. I would not be surprised if this was a short idea at first. Like, Pixar does a lot of shorts. I wouldn't be surprised if this was a short idea first. I got expanded to a full idea, and it, you know, they didn't overstay their welcome. You know, by the time when it's time to be over, they're like, okay, and that's the end of the story. And they you know, it ends on a happy note. And just surprisingly soulful and deep, and just a really good movie. I really liked it. I would vote for this movie for best animated feature. I would vote for this movie. Of the four I've seen, I would vote for this one. I thought it was going to be Encanto. I would vote for Luca. It really got me. And it was funny. You know, like, Pixar does a thing, knows how to strike the balance of earnest and funny well. And I need someone to help me explain why. Because I was talking about Kung Fu Panda in Raya and the Last Dragon, and Kung Fu Panda did the same thing where it took something that was very silly and had jokes throughout, but still it took the core message serious enough that it still, there was an emotional response for me. Like, there was like, it hit these emotional beats very well. And I can't explain why that worked and Raya and the Last Dragon did not work for me. You know, there's something to be said about a movie being silly and having silly messaging and having silly images, but still being like, yeah, but I got to tell you something for real, though. Like, here's something serious happening here. And it's not being overly earnest. It's just telling you these other things that's also happening. You know, when you meet this character, Alberto, in the movie, you know, he says, hey, you know, me and my dad came out from the water and we hang out, but he's not around that much anymore. So mainly I just do whatever I want. And you know, immediately when they say that, even though there's like jokes after that, your mind is like, wait, where's his dad though? Are we going to see his dad again? Where's his dad? And there's something to be said that later on, when you find out more about Alberto and his relationship with his father, it's just like there. And no matter what zany thing was happening, you're just like, oh man, that really strikes a chord. I don't know why they did this well, why Kung Fu Panda did this well, but Ryan the Last Dragon didn't. And maybe, I don't know, maybe someone smarter than me can tell me why I feel this way. But it's just, it's another, you just look at this and I'm just like immediately like, man, that Pixar touch. Like that, these are guys, these are veterans in the game. They've been doing this for a while. I don't think they're going to win. I think Encanto has way too much momentum. But I, you know, I definitely think that more people should see Luca. It's on Disney Plus right now. You should check it out. I give it 4 of 5 stars. Very good movie. I really enjoyed it. I don't really have that many complaints. You know, it started a little slow. And the bullying, there's a bad guy in it who's a little one-dimensional. I don't know how necessary he is, but I understand the point of him. So it was by no means my favorite Pixar movie, but it is a strong Pixar movie in a time when, you know, Pixar doesn't have a chokehold on animated films anymore. So feels like it could have been a classic. It could have been something that was more popular. And I'm not surprised that it's not though. I mean, it's not that I'm not surprised that it's not. It's just obviously not. And I think that's just the landscape of movies today, of especially animated features. So yeah, I give it 4 or 5 stars, which means I gave Mitchell and the Machines and Encanto both 3.5 of 5 stars. And I gave Ryan the Last Dragon 2.75 of 5 stars. And the only one left is Flea. Flea is an animated feature film and also nominated for Best Documentary. So I'm interested to see how that plays out in film form. I don't know. I could be nominated for those two different fields at the same time. But yeah, that'll probably be next up on the docket. But anyway, Luca, 4 of 5 stars. And with that, Leaving the Theater is a production of Oh It's Big Ron Studios. Theme music by the mysterious Breakmaster Cylinder. To find out more about this show and other Oh It's Big Ron Studios shows, follow me on Twitter and Instagram at Oh It's Big Ron. That's at OHITSBIGRON. If you like this show, I host another show on the Pushkin Industries podcast network called Solvable. Check that out wherever you listen. Leaving the Theater will be back soon, but until then, I'll be here on the couch.